I'm Santosh Kadankar. Today I am teaching you dynamic submersion. In dynamic submersion, I am focusing on the reciprocating muscle. This is the special problem. Four cylinder vertical engine has a crank 300 mm long. The crank is given, that is R is given. You are converted into meter. The plane of rotation of the first, third and fourth cranks are 750 mm. First, third and fourth are have written here. 1750, 1050 mm, 1650. With respect to that of second crank, the reciprocating masses are, the masses they are given 150, 400 and 250. Second crank, they are given the masses for the second crank. They are not given the second crank. Okay, respectively from the second crank and their respective masses. Okay, from the second crank, the respective masses are 150, 400. The masses given. These are the plane 1, 2, 3, and 4. The masses are M1 is 150, M2 we have to find out, M3 is 400, M4 is 250. First mass of reciprocating part of the second cylinder of relative angular position of the crank in order may be completed primary balance. Okay, the secondary force of the fourth cylinder is a rail is given, connecting rod length is given. Connecting rod length they have given it. And the speed they are given it, and balance secondary forces, so you have to find out. Okay, that's it. These are given here. The radius they are given. The radius is 0.3. Crank. 0.3 they are given it. Now fill this way. 0.3. The force is nothing but the multiplication of these two. Force is nothing but M into R. You have to multiply this one. You will obtain 45. 0.3 M through. 400 into this one is nothing but 120. 250 into 0.3 is nothing but 75. The distance plays an important. Here distance I am selecting the second. Why I have to select? I have to start from the 0. At 0 degree. If I taken at the center, it will start from here. It doesn't indicate 0 here. Therefore, I have to completely start from the horizontal line. Therefore, I will take the 2 as a reference plane. In the problem, they have selected the 2. The second crank, everything I have said is about the second crank. The distance, now from 2 to 1, we have taken as a negative, and this side we have to take as a positive. I will consider as a 0.75. If you measure it, 0.75. Next, 2 to 3, 2 is nothing but 0, 2 to 3 is nothing but 1.05, 2 to 4 is nothing but 1.65. The couple is nothing but M, R and L. This is nothing but L or A. Reference plane. I am considering L or A. Couple formula is C is proportional to M R L. M, R and L you have to multiply. M, R and L. You have to multiply in order to obtain a couple. 33.75. This will be 0 and this will be 126. If you multiply this, this and this you have to multiply. This, this and this you have to multiply. You will get 3.75. Now, here the angles are not given. The angles are not given here. Which are the angles are differing here? The reference plane cannot be taken as an angle. Therefore, you have to find out this one. Theta 2 you have to find out. I am considering the 1 as a 0. Theta 3 and theta 4. These are the unknown angles. Theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 and theta 4. We have to find out this one. How to find out? By using the primary couple concept. With the help of this one, you have to draw the diagram. From the diagram, you have to obtain theta 2 and theta 3. Or theta 4. You have to obtain it. Now first, these are the basic concept I have completed. Next, we will go for drawing the primary couple, because the primary couple, the couple here unknown is there is nothing unknown here. Here in the force there is one unknown, there is M2 is unknown. Therefore I will select the force polygon. Primary couple. Primary couple polygon. I will consider the scale here. Scale 1 cm is equal to 25 mm. Therefore 33.75 divided by 25 is nothing but 1.35. 126 divided by 25 is 5.04. 123.75 divided by 25 is 4.95. I will draw here. First 1.3 around here, 1.3, because it's negative, therefore I have to write in this direction. It is negative. Angle is 0. 0 here. Okay. These are unknown. Theta 2, theta 3, theta 4 are unknown. Next. 2.6. 2.6 nothing but 5.4. 5.4. Cut an arc of 5.4 here. Next to 4.9. From this point. Okay, now it's horizontal line. Now, if you measure the angle, this is minus 33.75, this is 126, this is 123.75. The angle plays an important role. 26 is nothing but theta 3. From this to there, the angle measured theta 3 is 281.5. And if you measure the angle of this one, this is theta 4. Theta 4 is 86. These are the values can be obtained. After knowing this value, substitute here. Theta 2 is nothing but, sorry, theta 2 we have to find out. Theta 3 is 281.5 and theta 4 is 86. Theta 2 is 86. Now, what is the 2 theta? 2 theta will be what? 281.5 into 2, you have to do it. That means 563 and 86. 172. Still, the theta 2 is unknown here. We have to find out. 2 theta 2 we have to find out here. How to find out? We have to follow the procedure. The same procedure we have to find out. We have completed the primary couple. Because there are 3 unknowns, therefore we have to go for graphical. In this way you have to move. Once you know, substitute here and you can follow the basic principles or basic formulas. Now I will go for primary forces. Primary force formula will be FPV is equal to M omega square R cos theta. Omega outside, omega square R, M will be inside because M varies here, cos theta. In previous cases the M was constant, but here 150, 400, 250. Therefore you have to take M inside. Now based on the formula you have to write the solution. Now omega square R I'm keeping outside here, so this is nothing but equal to 0 here. Now m is nothing but 150 cos 0 plus m2 cos theta 2 plus 400 cos 281.5 plus 250 cos 86 is equal to 0. This becomes 0 here. This value and this value. Count it. It becomes M2 cos theta 2 is equal to this. If it goes here, it becomes 0, and if we calculate, it becomes m2 cos. I will bring this value this side, it becomes minus 247.186, equation 1. Similarly, fp h m omega square r sin theta. In place of cos, you have to substitute the sin theta. I am directly writing here, 150 sin 0 plus m2 sin theta 2 plus 400 sin 281.5 plus 250 sin 86 degree. Therefore, m2 sin theta 2 is that this becomes 0. It goes this direction, it becomes 0. And this becomes 142.57, equation 2. Divide 2 by 1, divide 2 by 1, that is m2 sin theta 2 divided by m2 cos theta 2. m2 cancels, the sign will be 142.57 divided by minus 247.186. And this is nothing but second quadrant. Now, see the chart, sign positive and cos is negative here. Sin positive, cos negative, 180. You have to do the 180. 180. Therefore, you can write theta 2 is equal to 180 minus, this become tan inverse. This tan inverse 142.57 divided by 247.186. Then the answer will be 150.02 degree. Now, put in 1. If you substitute this value in 1, it becomes, if you substitute the equation in 1, the m2 become, m2 is nothing but 247.186 divided by cos 150.02. The answer will be 285.35 kg. And the primary force, we have done it, primary couple, we have obtained it through the graph. The primary force we have obtained analytical method. Next, we have to find out a secondary force and secondary couple. Secondary force, we have to find out formula for secondary couple. Secondary force formula will be MSV is equal to summation of m omega square r divided by n dash cos 2 theta omega square r n dash m omega cos 2 theta. Now, cos 2 theta plays an important role because here we don't know the 2 theta value. We have to find out here. How to find out? Omega square r n dash 150 cos 0 plus 150 cos 0 plus. Now, what is theta 2? Theta 2 is obtained here. 150 here. 150 point 0 to theta 2. And what is m value? M value is 285.35 kg. Now substitute here, you will get answer 150.02 into 2, nothing but 300.04. Now cos this much, and 285.35 cos 300.04 plus 400 cos 563 plus 250 cos 172. If you measure it, omega square r n dash is equal to minus 322.9214. Next, I will go for horizontal, that is summation of m omega square r divided by n dash in terms of sin theta. Replace in terms of sin theta, I am directly writing omega square r n dash. The answer for this one will be minus 368.51. In place of cos, just replace the sign. We will obtain the result. Now I will find out the resultant. The resultant will be omega square r divided by n dash. We have taken common here, root fsv square plus fsh square. Omega n r divided by n dash root minus 322.9214 whole square plus minus 368.51 whole square. What is omega? Omega is nothing but 31.41 whole square into 0.3 and n dash is 4.5. Minus 322.9214 whole square plus minus 368.51 whole square. The total answer will be 3222.6.99 newton. If you divide this one by 1000, it becomes 32.22 kilonewton. Now finding the secondary couple. Now secondary couple, the formula will be m sv summation of m omega square r divided by n dash. A will comes in picture. A cos 2 theta. Because the couple enters, you have to consider the distance. Now omega square r divided by n dash summation or you can take m a cos 2 theta. Now just you have to multiply the distance here. Distance, this is the distance. A is nothing but L or A, I have written it here. You have to multiply this distance. Now omega square r divided by n dash. M is nothing but 150 into minus 0.75 cos 0, because it is 0 here, cos 0 plus 285.35 into 0 into cos 300.04. It becomes, entire thing becomes 0 here. 400 plus 400 into 1.05 into cos 563 plus 250 into cos, sorry, into 1.65 into cos 172. It becomes omega square r n dash minus 907.59. Similarly, if you go for sine terms, in terms of sine, you have to replace, in place of cos, you have to replace sine. MSH is equal to summation of m omega square r divided by n dot a sine 2 theta. In place of cos, you have to replace the sine. Then the answer will be omega square r divided by n dash minus 106.69. Now find out the resultant. Finding the resultant of this one, we will get the final answer. The resultant ms is equal to omega square r divided by n dash is equal to root mh square plus msv square, 31.41 square into 0.3 divided by 4.5 root minus 907.59 square plus minus 0.6.69 whole square. The answer will be 60105.53 newton meter divided by 1000. You will get 60.105 kilo newton meter. I am Satish Gaidankar. Thank you very much.